friends, I'm CA Deepak Gupta, and I welcome you all in our today's webinar session. And our topic of today's session is Companies Fresh Startup Scheme 2020 and LLP Settlement Scheme 2020. Friends, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, in an attempt to ease matter for the companies, has introduced a new scheme known as Company Fresh Startup Scheme, CFSS. And you must be knowing that the idea behind this scheme is that to provide the clean state to all the law-abiding companies, giving them extended time and a certain level of financial relief with regards to the compliance considering current global situation. Friends, this is very hot topic, and we were getting many queries, and many participants had asked us to conduct one webinar on this topic. Therefore, we are conducting one webinar on this topic. And friends, during this tough time of COVID-19, we are trying to empower education and by way of conducting webinars. Through this series, the webinars, we want to enhance knowledge of all the participants, and we are also trying to focus on to find young and some energetic speakers, and therefore, and also we are trying that from our platform where the new speakers can come and speak. And in that attempt, today we have very young speaker between us, CA Pratibha Goyal, and about her, Sangamji will tell more about her. Now over to you, Sangamji.
Thank you, Deepakji. Thank you for initiating this webinar.
Thank you, sir.
As you know that now lockdown has been extended up to 3rd May. So it is a good opportunity for all of us to learn through webinars. So friends, the world as a whole is in lockdown currently due to the unprecedented situation regarding public health and safety caused by the COVID-19. The Ministry of Corporate Affairs, in an attempt to ease the matter of companies, has introduced a new scheme known as the Company Fresh Start Scheme 2020. Additionally, the MCA also given an LLP a bit of breathing space by making certain necessary changes to LLP Settlement Scheme 2020. The idea behind this is to provide a clean slate to all those law-abiding companies, giving them extended time and a certain level of financial relief with regard to compliances concerning the current global situation. Friend, this is the main thing why the MCA has launched this two schemes for company and for LLP. So now come on the speaker part. The following is the brief part of CA Pratibha Goyal is a very young and dynamic chartered accountant. She qualified in 2016. She completed her graduation from Delhi University, and she became chartered accountant at the early age of 23. She has written more than 300 articles from various professional websites. She is very active on YouTube. She has also been expressed her view on YouTube on various subjects like income tax, GST, company law, etc. Friend, she is the among us because she is a part of the team Study Cafe. Also, she is a daughter of our very near and dear friend, CA Ajay Goyal. So please welcome, I invite Pratibha ji to speak on this very important topic today. So please start.
Thank you, Sangam sir. So first of all, before starting with the topic, before starting the topic, I want to thank CA Sangam Agarwal and CA Deepak Gupta, who are taking this very beautiful initiative of organizing the webinar. This is indeed a very appreciative job which you are doing. So this provide a very good platform for budding speakers like us. And again, it is a source of knowledge for, you know, the participants. So with this note, I am starting with the topic. Let me share my screen. Let me share the PPT with you. So I hope you all are able to see my screen.
Yes, we are able to see.
Okay. So friends, okay, before going forward, I just want to ask you one thing. I hope,
disturb you. Today, yeah. Friends, we have don't have a chat box. We have Q&A option available to write your questions. So friend, whatever question you have, please write in Q&A. Today, chat option is not available. Thank you. Please continue.
Okay. Okay, so before starting with the PPT, I just want to ask one thing. I hope you guys are at home and you are safe and following the government guidelines. I understand that this is little bit frustrating, but at this point of time, this is something which is the need of hour. And now let's start with the topic. So my topic is Company Fresh Start Scheme. You know, as the name suggests, this is a chance to make a fresh start. Friends, you know, before saying before going forward, I just want to explain what was the reason why this scheme was introduced. See, understand, COVID-19 was not just a reason. Indeed, it was one of the reasons, but the actual reason was that there were a large number of companies who have not done their compliances from a very long period of time. So, you know, they were suffering with heavy additional fees, like mere hi kuch clients the, and they were having a share capital of like 1 lakh, 2 lakh, and they were having additional fees of 50,000, 60,000. So, you know, it was this kind of situation which was prevalent. So, there were many representations with the MCA. So, that the portion of additional fee, a scheme should be introduced where the portion of additional fees is waived off. Earlier also there have been schemes, but this is for the first time when additional fees has been completely waived off. So with this note, let's go further. So this is Company Fresh Start Scheme 2020. So this is something they have given a chance to the companies which have done default of non-compliance. They have not filed certain document on time. So now chance is being given to them that they can file the document and they don't need to pay any additional fee. Normal fee will be paid, but they don't need to pay any additional fee for the same. So now let's go further. Just want to recall, this is something like condonation, and concept of condonation is not new. You know, there have been in past also, in 2014 there was CODS 2014 and there was CODS 2018 also, but wo hamesha kehte the ki hum aapke upar penalty waive off kar denge, prosecution nahi hoga, but additional fees ka koi na koi portion hamesha hota tha. ये पहली बार हुआ है. द यूएसपी ऑफ द स्कीम इज कि एडिशनल फीस को 100% वेव ऑफ कर दिया गया है. सो दिस इज अ गोल्डन अपॉर्चुनिटी, वन टाइम गोल्डन अपॉर्चुनिटी. आई रिक्वेस्ट कि आप अपने क्लाइंट्स को आगे सजेस्ट कीजिए, अगर उनका कोई ना कोई नॉन कंप्लायंस है तो वो फॉर्म को फाइल करके इस गोल्डन अपॉर्चुनिटी को अवेल करें. ओके फ्रेंड्स, हम सबको पता है कि अगर सरकार को कोई चीज इंट्रोड्यूस करनी होती है तो वो सर्कुलर के थ्रू नहीं होती. हमेशा एक्ट में कोई ना कोई एक ऐसा सेक्शन होता है जो उस चीज के इंट्रोडक्शन के पीछे होता है, जो सरकार को एम्पावर करता है कि हम वो स्कीम को इंट्रोड्यूस कर सकें. तो लेट्स डिस्कस कि ये सेक्शंस क्या हैं. ये सेक्शन सर्कुलर में भी मेंशनड है, यहाँ पे मैंने सेक्शंस को थोड़ा एक्सप्लेन किया है. So let's start with section 403. Section 403 को हम पढ़ते हैं companies office and fees rules के साथ हम पढ़ते हैं. Basically ये section हमें बताता है कि अगर हम time पे कोई document file करते हैं तो हमें क्या fees देनी है, और अगर हम delay कर देते हैं वो document की filing में तो हमें क्या additional fees देनी है. साथ ही साथ वो ये भी बताता है कि हमारे ऊपर क्या prosecution या penalty हो सकता है, और उसके जो लिमिट्स हैं, जो एक्चुअली नंबर्स हैं, वो आपके रूल्स में स्पेसिफाइड है. नंबर्स और प्रोसीजर्स जो होता है वो रूल्स में स्पेसिफाइड है. देयरफॉर गवर्नमेंट ने एक चांस दिया कि जो सेक्शन 403 में आपका एडिशनल फीस, पेनल्टी या प्रोसिक्यूशन लग रहा था उसको वेव ऑफ करने का चांस दिया, और वो वेव ऑफ करने का चांस दिया CFSS 2020. सो नाउ यू विल आस्क, ठीक है ये तो आपने बता दिया, लेकिन सेक्शन कौन सा सेक्शन ऐसा है जो हमें एम्पावर करता है कि वो फीस को वेव ऑफ कर दिया जाए, वो डिले को कंडोन कर दिया जाए. ये एम्पावरमेंट गवर्नमेंट को मिलती है सेक्शन 460 ऑफ कंपनीज एक्ट. आई विल रीड द बेयर सेक्शन फॉर यू. द सेक्शन इज ऑल अबाउट कंडोनेशन ऑफ डिले ऑफ इन सर्टन केसेस. सेक्शन 460, Notwithstanding anything contained in this act, सबसे पहले तो ये जो section शुरू होता है, it starts with notwithstanding. See, since it starts with notwithstanding, it means ये किसी ना किसी चीज को overrule कर रहा है. अभी किसको ओवर रूल कर रहा है, ये पूरी एक्ट को ओवर रूल कर रहा है. तो फ्रेंड्स दिस इज वेरी पावरफुल सेक्शन. सो लेट्स रीड फर्दर. Where any application is required to be made in respect of any matter to central government and it is not made within time, then government for reasons given in writing condone the delay. And similarly, where any document is required to be filed with registrar and it is not filed within time, then the government for reasons recorded in writing may condone the delay. Okay, before explaining this section, I want to discuss what is the difference between an application and document. See, there is very important, this is very important to know. Maybe some of you know, but some of you don't know. So I am explaining the difference with the help of an example. Practically bata rahi hu, school mein jab aapko chutti leni hoti thi, to you used to give application. And documentation is something, jab hum koi kaam kar lete hain, तो एज अ प्रूफ हम जो चीज रखते हैं जब हम ऑडिट पे जाते हैं तो वी कीप डॉक्यूमेंटेशन. सो आई विल गिव यू द एग्जांपल विद द हेल्प ऑफ कंपनी लॉ. सी सपोज आई वांट टू अपॉइंट समवन एज द एमडी ऑफ द कंपनी. नाउ फॉर अपॉइंटिंग हिम एज अ एमडी आई नीड टू कंप्लाई विद द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ शेड्यूल 5, बट द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ शेड्यूल 5 इज नॉट फुलफिल्ड. इन दिस केस आई नीड टू मेक application to government and application has to be made before his appointment. Ab kya hua? Appointment is complete. I have been given the approval. After I get the approval, I'll appoint him as the director of the company. And for appointing, I need to pass board resolution. I'll give him the appointment letter. There would be a lot of documentation. And then that documentation would be filed with ROC with the help of DIR 12. So I hope friends, with this example, you have understood the difference between the application and document. And if I'll show you the list of, you know, the forms, I'll show you later on, the application related documents are always covered. So in short, yes, government had power to condone the delay in cases of application also and in case of document also. And the condonation of delay has been done through CFSS 2020 scheme. I hope, friends, you have understood the governing provisions. So now, okay, this is something, what is the meaning of fresh start? You know, the word fresh start can be understood jab aap koi document पहले फाइल करते हो तो आप सिर्फ आप नॉर्मल फीस देते हो. यू डोंट गिव एडिशनल फीस. एडिशनल फीस आप तभी देते हो जब आप लेट हो जाते हो. तो एमसीए बोलता है कि अब आपके डॉक्यूमेंट को जो कि पुराने हो गए उसको एज अ फ्रेश डॉक्यूमेंट एक्सेप्ट करेंगे एंड विद नॉर्मल फीस एक्सेप्ट करेंगे. सो यू नो दिस कैन बी इन्फर्ड विद द वर्ड फ्रेश स्टार्ट. So now, what are the benefits of opting the scheme? I think ये आप अपने clients को समझा सकते हो कि क्या benefit है. सबसे बड़ा benefit तो ये है that you have been given a chance to become more compliant and you don't need to pay any additional fee for that. Then you are being given immunity from prosecution. You are being given immunity from penalty. So these are some of the benefits of opting CFSS 2020 scheme. We'll go forward now. So the period of the scheme is, it is applicable from 1st April 2020 till 30th September 2020. Again, this is something very important. Scheme is applicable on defaulting company and the term defaulting company has been defined in the circular. It simply means a company which is defined in Companies Act and it has not filed certain document statement etc with the MCA registry. Friends, I just want to highlight here, this scheme is only for active company. Now agar aap circular dekhenge to it is written that the scheme is also for inactive company, but here I am saying this scheme is only for active company. I'll explain this in detail in the later segment of the presentation. Second, this scheme can be availed by active non-compliant company. There is MCA advisory for that. This is the advisory. It's there on the MCA website as well. So the advisory is, in case you are an active non-compliant company, first you need to file the form INC 22A active. you become active, then you file rest of the form. So this is the mechanism. And again, in case of directors whose DINs have been marked as deactivated for non-KYC purpose, they need to complete their KYC forms, and then you can sign the forms. So this is the MC advisory, and it also says that you don't need to file any, you don't need to pay any additional fees for the same. So it's there on the portal as well. Now, forms which can be filed under this scheme, although there is a list of 76 forms, it's there on the MC website. I'll share you the forms after the webinar as well. These are some of the forms which I have compiled. I won't explain the forms, but yes, I've just given it here also. And form SH7, CHG1489, it cannot be filed. This is description of some of the form. I won't discuss all the forms with you, but here, two forms which I wanted to discuss, because this is something which I've seen practically. ADT3, especially because I want to discuss, because I think many CA brothers and sisters are also here. So, I've seen CAs ko agar resignation dena hota hai company se, what they do is they give the resignation, but they don't file ADT3. They think wo file karna to meri responsibility hai hi nahi. Friends, ADT3 file karna auditor ki responsibility hota hai. Aur agar aap as a auditor ADT3 file nahi kar rahe ho, to it is a non-compliance. So, प्लीज़ ये मेरे सीए फ्रेंड्स से रिक्वेस्ट है कि अगर किसी ने पास्ट में किसी कंपनी से रिजाइन किया है तो प्लीज़ एक बार चेक कर लें कि आपका ADT3 फाइल हुआ है, और अगर नहीं हुआ है तो दिस इज अ गुड टाइम दैट दे कैन फाइल द फॉर्म. And similarly, I want to highlight DIR 11 also. बहुत सारे directors जब company से resign करते हैं, तो company क्या होता है? DIR 12 file कर देती है. They think DIR 12 file हो गया, MCA के database में आ गया, बस खत्म काम. नहीं, इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट. इट्स अ टू वे मैकेनिज्म. कंपनी DIR 12 फाइल करती है, और जो डायरेक्टर होता है उसको DIR 11 फाइल करना होता है, एंड DIR 11 फाइल करना डायरेक्टर की रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी होती है. तो अगर आपने एज अ डायरेक्टर पास्ट में रिजाइन किया है, तो प्लीज एक बार चेक कर लो कि DIR 11 फाइल हुआ है नहीं हुआ, और अगर नहीं हुआ है तो दिस इज द राइट टाइम व्हेन यू कैन फाइल द फॉर्म. अच्छा, पीपल ऑल्सो आस्क मी कि हम चेक कैसे करें. आई थिंक यू ऑल नो देयर इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इंस्पेक्शन. आप एमसीए पे जाके 100 रुपीज पे करके यू कैन इंस्पेक्ट द डॉक्यूमेंट्स. यू कैन यूज दैट मैकेनिज्म ऑल्सो, और अदरवाइज ऑल्सो देयर इज अ ऑप्शन. यू कैन चेक विदाउट पेइंग द फीस एज वेल. आप देख सकते हो कि कौन सी कंपनी ने कौन सी ईयर में कौन कौन से डॉक्यूमेंट्स फाइल किए हैं, एंड देन द प्रोफेशनल्स कैन फाइंड द वे. नेक्स्ट, okay, which forms cannot be filed. Okay, I have a confusion here, I'll discuss with you. When the circular came, this was the list. It was written form SH7, where increase in authorized capital is involved. Then there was CHG 1, 4, 8, and 9. The CHG forms are filed in case of charge. So now, what the confusion which I faced was, when the circular came, they wrote, specifically they wrote form SH7, and then they wrote increase in authorized capital. Now, SH7 is filed under these four circumstances: increase in authorized capital, increase in number of members, consolidation or division, and in case of redemption of redeemable preference share. My conclusion was कि ठीक है, authorized share capital के केस में मैं SH7 file नहीं कर सकती, लेकिन इसका मतलब तो ये हुआ कि बाकी तीनों केसेस में मैं शायद SH7 file कर सकती हूँ. But जो आपकी MCA की list निकली forms की, उसमें SH7 कहीं भी नहीं है. आप लोग check कर सकते हैं, उस list में SH7 का नाम नहीं है. So I am confused if SH7 can be opted for these three options or not. I hope MCA is teen points pe future mein kuch clarification dega. So this is something which requires clarification as far as my understanding is concerned. We'll go further. Again, there is one more confusion. Can a foreign company apply? See, if you read the circular, company has been defined in the circular itself. Aur agar company ko circular ke andar define kiya gaya hai, to main yahi samjhungi ki yahan pe jo terminology company use kari hai, wo usi definition specific hai. उसी चीज के लिए करिए जो कि सर्कुलर में डिफाइन किया है. सर्कुलर में कंपनी को डिफाइन किया गया मींस अ कंपनी डिफाइंड इन क्लॉज 20 ऑफ सेक्शन 2 ऑफ कंपनीज एक्ट. अब कंपनीज एक्ट में क्या लिखा है, इट इज अ कंपनी व्हिच इज इनकॉर्पोरेटेड अंडर दिस एक्ट और अंडर एनी प्रीवियस लॉ. प्रीवियस लॉ मतलब जो हमारा पुराना कंपनीज एक्ट था. अगेन फॉरेन कंपनी हैज बीन डिफाइंड, वो कंपनी जो कि इंडिया के बाहर इनकॉर्पोरेट हुई है. तो अगर मैं इस चीज को बहुत ही स्ट्रिक्टली इंटरप्रेट करूं तो फॉरेन कंपनी कैन नॉट पार्टिसिपेट इन द स्कीम, क्योंकि कंपनी की सर्कुलर में लिखा है कि ये सिर्फ डिफॉल्टिंग कंपनी के लिए है. डिफॉल्टिंग कंपनी के कंपनी वर्ड को आपने सर्कुलर में डिफाइन कर दिया. वो कंपनी जो कि क्लॉज 20 ऑफ सेक्शन 2 में आती है. क्लॉज 20 केवल अगर मैं कॉमन पार्लेंस में बात करूं डोमेस्टिक कंपनी की बात करता है, वो तो फॉरेन कंपनी की बात नहीं करता क्योंकि फॉरेन कंपनी स्पेसिफिकली डिफाइंड है. तो अगर मैं स्ट्रिक्टली इंटरप्रेट करूं तो आपका जो फॉरेन कंपनी है उसके लिए ये स्कीम नहीं है. लेकिन जो 76 फॉर्म्स की लिस्ट आई एमसीए की आप चेक कर लीजिए, उसमें ये चारों फॉर्म्स कवर्ड हैं. अगेन आई थिंक दिस इज समथिंग विच रिक्वायर्स क्लेरिफिकेशन. अब इस पे मैं कुछ और भी बोलना चाहूंगी. फ्रेंड्स अंडरस्टैंड, जब एक्ट में कोई एग्जेम्पशन दी जाती है तो हमें कहा जाता है कि उसको बहुत स्ट्रिक्टली इंटरप्रेट करो. जो सीधे सीधे साफ साफ शब्दों में लिखा है उसको फॉलो करो, और कहीं भी कंफ्यूजन है तो एग्जेम्पशन मत लो, ऐसा कहा जाता है. लेकिन जब सरकार कभी भी इम्यूनिटी देती है ना, तो इम्यूनिटी अगर किसी ऐसा नहीं होगा कि अगर किसी एक को दे रही है तो किसी दूसरे को नहीं देगी. इम्यूनिटी को हमेशा वाइडर सेंस में लिया जाता है. और अगर मैं इस चीज को वाइडर सेंस में देखूं तो हाँ, ये फॉरेन कंपनीज पर भी अप्लाई होना चाहिए. बट अगेन दिस इज माय पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. एमसीए पर कोई इस चीज का क्लेरिफिकेशन नहीं आया है एंड दिस इज समथिंग अबाउट विच आई हैव अ कंफ्यूजन. सो नाउ लेट्स मूव फॉरवर्ड विद द डिस्कशन. What are the exceptions on which this scheme is not applicable? Friends, मैंने आपको starting में बोला था कि this scheme is only for active company. तो साफ सी बात है, अगर कोई company को MCA ने खुद ही strike off कर दिया है या फिर उसने strike off की application दे दिया तो वो ये scheme में participate नहीं कर सकती. And again, understand, आपको MCA कब strike off करता है, जब आपने बहुत ही high level of default किया होता है. Because strike off का भी अपना एक procedure है, आपको कोई ऐसे ही strike off नहीं कर देता. तो obviously इतना अगर आपने serious non-compliance किया है तो you cannot participate in this scheme. और अगर आपने खुद ही strike off के लिए apply कर दिया, that means you don't want to work as a company. So immunity किस बात की. Again exception, अगर आप का amalgamation हो गया है, you know, अब जिस कंपनी का amalgamation होता है उसकी अपनी आइडेंटिटी वैसे ही लूज हो जाती है. एंड देन इन केस यू हैव फाइल्ड एप्लीकेशन फॉर ऑब्टेनिंग द स्टेटस ऑफ डोरमेंट कंपनी एंड इन केस यू आर अ वैनिशिंग कंपनी. फ्रेंड्स आई विल डिस्कस द डेफिनेशन ऑफ डोरमेंट कंपनी एंड वैनिशिंग कंपनी विद यू. सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ डोरमेंट कंपनी. I have discussed the definition of dormant company because आगे चल के dormant company का एक concept है. Dormant company वो company होती है जिसको या तो आप किसी future project के लिए लेते हो. मैं आपको एक example बताती हूँ. एक person को एक idea आया, ठीक है. Now what he wants to do is he wants to utilize this idea in future and he thought of a company and he thought of a name of a company. Now आपको पता है आइडिया पे किसी और का जोर नहीं है. हो सकता है कोई नाम जो आपको पसंद आया है फ्यूचर में किसी और को पसंद आए. यू वॉन्ट टू रिजर्व दैट नेम. फॉर दैट उसने क्या किया, एक कंपनी बना के रख दी कि इस नाम की इस कंपनी में मैं फ्यूचर में कोई प्रोजेक्ट करूंगा एंड देन आई यूज दैट कंपनी. सो यस, फॉर दैट पर्पस डोरमेंट कंपनी इज क्रिएटेड. अगेन इट इज क्रिएटेड टू होल्ड असेट और इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी. ऐसी बहुत सारी कंपनीज मैंने देखी हैं जो सिर्फ और सिर्फ लैंड और बिल्डिंग, ये बहुत ही कॉमन एग्जाम्पल है, या फिर कोई हैवी इन्वेस्टमेंट को होल्ड करने के लिए बनाई जाती है, उसमें कोई और ट्रांजेक्शन नहीं होती. एंड हैज नो सिग्निफिकेंट अकाउंटिंग ट्रांजेक्शन. नाउ व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंट अकाउंटिंग ट्रांजेक्शन. सिग्निफिकेंट अकाउंटिंग ट्रांजेक्शन इज अ वेरी बिग इंक्लूसिव टर्म. हमारा कंपनी का कहता है कि हम सारी ट्रांजेक्शन को सिग्निफिकेंट अकाउंटिंग ट्रांजेक्शन मानेंगे, सिर्फ ये चार ट्रांजेक्शन को छोड़ के। वो चार ट्रांजेक्शन कौन सी है? आपने आरओसी फीस की पेमेंट करी, आपने कोई लॉ के अंडर पेमेंट करी, आपने शेयर्स की अलॉटमेंट की विच इज रिक्वायर्ड अंडर दिस एक्ट, आपने पेमेंट फॉर मेंटेनेंस ऑफ ऑफिस एंड रिकॉर्ड्स। ये चार ट्रांजेक्शन के अलावा कोई भी ट्रांजेक्शन आपने करी उसको मैं सिग्निफिकेंट अकाउंटिंग ट्रांजेक्शन मानूंगा। तो अब ये क्राइटेरिया अगर आप फुलफिल कर रहे हैं तो देन यू कैन गिव अ एप्लीकेशन टू रजिस्ट्रार एंड देन you can obtain status of a dormant company. So now I come on vanishing company. What is the meaning of vanishing company? Vanishing company कहीं भी companies act में define नहीं है. I think what I remember is 2014 में अरुण जेटली ने vanishing companies की एक list निकाली थी और उन्होंने वो vanishing companies को prosecution और penalty में डाला था. तो वैनिशिंग कंपनी क्या होता है? एक कमेटी बनी थी, कोऑर्डिनेशन एंड मॉनिटरिंग कमेटी। दिस इज यू नो द एमसीए लिंक फॉर दैट इफ यू कैन इफ यू वांट टू सी। उस कमेटी ने बोला कि वैनिशिंग कंपनी वो होगी जिसने मार्केट से पैसा उठाया लेकिन उसने कोई भी कंप्लायंस नहीं किया दो साल तक। उसने जो रजिस्टर्ड ऑफिस बताया है उसके ऊपर उसका कोई एड्रेस नहीं है और उसके कोई भी डायरेक्टर्स का अता पता नहीं है। तो ऑब्वियसली ऐसी कंपनीज को तो कोई भी स्कीम में इम्यूनिटी मिलनी भी नहीं चाहिए और मिलेगी भी नहीं। नाउ दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट, इनएक्टिव कंपनीज। मैंने आपसे स्टार्टिंग में बोला था कि ये स्कीम सिर्फ और सिर्फ एक्टिव कंपनीज के लिए है, लेकिन ये इनएक्टिव कंपनीज के लिए कैसे यूजफुल है वो मैं आपको एक्सप्लेन करती हूँ। So you know I have explained this in form of flowchart. Inactive company वो है जो कि कोई business और operation नहीं कर रही, उसने कोई significant accounting transaction नहीं करी दो साल तक। significant accounting transaction I have explained, और उसने दो साल तक कोई financials file नहीं किए। Mind you friends, inactive company होना कोई अच्छी बात नहीं होती। और please, inactive company वो नहीं है जिसने INC 20A active नहीं file किया। It is altogether a different concept. ठीक है, इनएक्टिव कंपनी होना इज नॉट अ गुड थिंग। आई होप इस फ्लोचार्ट की हेल्प से आपको इनएक्टिव कंपनी का डेफिनेशन समझ आ गया। इनएक्टिव कंपनी के लिए क्या स्कीम है? इनएक्टिव कंपनी को एमसीए ने बोला कि आप ऐसा कीजिए, सीएफएसएस 2020 में जो भी डॉक्यूमेंट्स आपके पेंडिंग है वो फाइल कर दीजिए, वो फाइल करके आपको एक्टिव कर देंगे और जब आप एक्टिव हो जाओगे उसके बाद यू कैन अप्लाई फॉर डॉर्मेंसी। यू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ डॉर्मेंट कंपनी, दैट इज द रीजन आई एक्सप्लेन यू द मीनिंग ऑफ डॉर्मेंट कंपनी। और अगर आपको काम ही नहीं करना तो आप अपना नाम कटवा लो। तो देखा जाए आइडियली इनएक्टिव कंपनी के पास थ्री ऑप्शंस हैं। पहला ऑप्शन कि वो एक्टिव हो जाए, दूसरा ऑप्शन वो अपना नाम कटवा ले, वो स्ट्राइक ऑफ करा ले, और तीसरा ऑप्शन वो डॉर्मेंसी के लिए अप्लाई कर दे। तो आई होप फ्रेंड्स आपको ये मेरी बात समझ आ गई कि ये स्कीम सिर्फ और सिर्फ एक्टिव कंपनी के लिए और ऐसा क्यों है। So with this note, we'll move further. Okay, this is something, I think this is a question जो आप लोग अपने practically बहुत face करोगे कि अगर आपकी company के सारे director disqualified हैं तो क्या तब भी आप इस scheme में participate कर सकते हो? तो friends, सबसे पहले तो I just want to say, इस scheme की वजह से किसी director की disqualification नहीं हटेगी। मेरे से लोगों ने आके पूछा कि मैम ऐसा करता हूँ, इस scheme में अपने सारे documents file कर देता हूँ, जब मेरी फाइलिंग कंप्लीट हो जाएगी तो मेरी डिस्क्वालिफिकेशन हट जाएगी। नहीं, ऐसा नहीं है, प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड। जब आप डिस्क्वालिफाई होते हैं तो एज पर द एक्ट यू कैन नॉट बी अ डायरेक्टर, यू आर सपोज टू वेकेट योर ऑफिस, आपका ऑफिस खाली हो जाता है। तो ऐसे केसेस में क्या प्रोसीजर है? यू कैन रेफर सेक्शन 167(3), आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू इन सिंपल वर्ड्स। ऐसे केसेस में क्या होता है कि प्रमोटर्स को और शेयर होल्डर्स को दे कैन कॉल अ ईजीएम एंड उसके बाद दे कैन अपॉइंट रिक्वायर्ड नंबर ऑफ पर्सन्स एज डायरेक्टर ऑफ द कंपनी एंड दे कैन होल्ड द ऑफिस टिल द नेक्स्ट जनरल मीटिंग। सो दिस इज अ प्रोसीजर। एंड आरओसी में बैकएंड में ये फैसिलिटी अवेलेबल है कि वो बैकएंड से, क्योंकि आपको फाइलिंग के पर्पस के लिए बैकएंड से वो डायरेक्टर्स को अपॉइंट करवा देते हैं एंड आपको फिजिकली फॉर्म सबमिट करने होते हैं आरओसी पे। तो yes, what company can do is backend से if they are, it is possible for them to appoint two people as the director, then they can participate in the scheme after the directors have been appointed. But again, इस स्कीम की वजह से डिस्क्वालिफिकेशन नहीं हटेगी. जो पर्सन डिस्क्वालिफाई हो चुके हैं उनके लिए आपको जो लीगल प्रोसीजर है कोर्ट में जाना वो आपको करना ही पड़ेगा, उसके बिना आपकी डिस्क्वालिफिकेशन नहीं हटेगी. अगेन वन मोर थिंग, अगर आपका डिन एक्टिवेट हुआ दैट इज अ डिफरेंट थिंग. डिस्क्वालिफिकेशन एंड डिन एक्टिवेशन इज अ डिफरेंट थिंग. अगर डिन एक्टिवेट हुआ है तो आप DIR3 KYC फाइल कीजिए और फिर आप अपने बाकी डॉक्यूमेंट्स को साइन कर सकते हैं, बट डिस्क्वालिफिकेशन नहीं हटेगी. So I hope friends you have understood the concept, and with this we'll go further. How appeals are affected, this is again a very important concept. जो भी सर्कुलर में ये लिखा है कि अगर आपको स्कीम में पार्टिसिपेट करना है तो अगर आपने कोई अपील फाइल करी थी तो पहले आपको उसको विड्रॉ करना है, तभी आप इस सर्कुलर में पार्टिसिपेट कर सकते हैं. So this is the concept. I'll explain it in further slides also because it is a big concept. Again, this is important. Please listen carefully. What if the order of adjudication authority was passed but the appeal was not filed? Okay, I'll explain. Okay, before explaining this with the help of example, I just want to tell you. Section 454(6) में लिखा है कि जब आपके ऊपर कोई adjudication authority order pass करती है तो order मिलने के 60 दिन के अंदर अंदर आपको हायर अथॉरिटी पे अपील फाइल करनी पड़ती है. दिस इज समथिंग विच इज रिटन इन द क्वेश्चन इन द सेक्शन. विल गो फर्दर, आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू विद द हेल्प ऑफ एग्जांपल. 20th दिसंबर 2019 को मैंने डिफॉल्ट कमिट किया, ठीक है. 21st फेब 2020 को आई रिसीव्ड द ऑर्डर. नाउ इफ माय कैलकुलेशन इज करेक्ट, 21st April 2020 तक मुझे अपील फाइल करनी है, बट हुआ क्या, आई थिंक लॉकडाउन स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम मार्च. सो इफ एवरीथिंग इज इन पोजीशन ऑफ लॉकडाउन देन हाउ कैन आई फाइल द अपील. सो इन दिस केस आई हैव गॉट द रिलीफ एंड आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू व्हाई दिस रिलीफ इज इम्पोर्टेंट. फर्स्ट लेट्स नो व्हाट इज द रिलीफ. रिलीफ इज दैट यू आर बीइंग गिवन अ additional period of 120 days, and the 120 days would be given from, if I take this example, 21st April 2020, from 21st April the 120 days would be given, and in during this period 120 days no prosecution would be initiated. Again, if the last day, suppose if this date was not 21st April, it was 29th Feb 2020, in that case this scheme cannot be this scheme cannot provide you relief, because you have to file appeal between 1st March to your period should be between 1st March to 31st May. So why this is a relief, now I explain you why this is a relief. Why this is a relief, so for that we need to read this. स्कीम में लिखा है कि हमें कब कब इम्यूनिटी नहीं मिलेगी. अगर कोई अपील पेंडिंग है, स्कीम क्लियरली सेज आपको पहले अपील विड्रॉ करनी है, उसके बाद आपको इम्यूनिटी मिलेगी. कंपनी के अंदर कोई मैनेजमेंट डिस्प्यूट चल रहे हैं, पहले आप अपने मैनेजमेंट डिस्प्यूट्स को रिजॉल्व करो. नाउ दीज टू पॉइंट्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड दे आर इंटरकनेक्टेड विद द प्रीवियस स्लाइड्स. एनी कोर्ट हैज ऑर्डर्ड conviction on any matter and no appeal has been preferred against such orders of the court before the scheme has come into force. And the second point is, an order imposing penalty has been passed by the adjudication authority under this act and no appeal has been preferred against such orders of adjudication authority before the scheme has come into force. So again, I'll go back to the example. आपको 21st अप्रैल को अपील फाइल करनी थी, आप नहीं कर पाए, आपको रिलीफ मिला, आपको 120 दिन का एडिशन टाइम पीरियड मिला, आपको इस 120 दिन के टाइम पीरियड में पहले अपील फाइल करनी है और उस अपील को फाइल करने के बाद विड्रॉ करना है, उस अपील को फाइल करने के बाद विड्रॉ करना है, तभी आप इस स्कीम में पार्टिसिपेट कर सकते हैं. क्योंकि अगर आपने कोई अपील फाइल नहीं की, सबसे पहले तो अगर आपने कोई अपील फाइल नहीं की, अगर आप थर्ड और फोर्थ पॉइंट देखेंगे तो इन दैट केस आपको कोई इम्यूनिटी नहीं मिलेगी. और अगर आपकी अपील पेंडिंग है तो भी आप स्कीम में पार्टिसिपेट नहीं कर सकते. आई होप फ्रेंड्स आपको ये एग्जाम्पल की हेल्प से ये पूरा कॉन्सेप्ट समझ आ गया है. सो विद दिस नोट विल गो फर्दर नाउ. अगेन वॉट इज द प्रोसीजर अंडर CFSS 2020 स्कीम. इट इज अ वेरी सिंपल प्रोसीजर, कोई ज्यादा तामझाम नहीं है. आपको क्या करना है, जो भी डिफॉल्टिंग कंपनी है उसको अपने सारे पेंडिंग फॉर्म्स नॉर्मल फीस के साथ अपनी डेजिग्नेटेड अथॉरिटी पे फाइल करने. डेजिग्नेटेड अथॉरिटी कौन होगी, आपकी जुरिसडिक्शनल ROC आपकी डेजिग्नेटेड अथॉरिटी है. जब आप अपने सारे डिफॉल्ट्स को ठीक कर देंगे तो उसके बाद आपको CFSS 2020 फाइल करना है. ये आपको फाइल करना है विद इन 6 months ऑफ द क्लोजर ऑफ द स्कीम. यानी आपकी स्कीम खत्म हो रही है 30th September को, तो 1st October 2020 से लेके जो 31st March 2021 का जो पीरियड है उसके पीरियड के बीच के टाइम में आपको CFSS 2020 फाइल करना ही करना है. आई डिस्कस द फॉर्म विद यू आल्सो. देन जब आप ये सब कर लेंगे तो आपको इम्यूनिटी सर्टिफिकेट मिलेगा अपनी एक डेजिग्नेटेड अथॉरिटी से. ओके, सो आई होप फ्रेंड्स आपको ये प्रोसीजर समझ आ गया, बिकॉज इट इज अ वेरी सिंपल प्रोसीजर. अगेन दिस इज समथिंग विच इज वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट, दिस कॉन्सेप्ट इज वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट. इम्यूनिटी शैल बी ओनली फ्रॉम द लॉन्च ऑफ प्रोसिक्यूशन और प्रोसीडिंग्स टू इम्पोज द पेनल्टी फॉर डिफॉल्ट इन फाइलिंग. Any other consequential proceedings related to the default shall not be immunized. This is a very important concept and circular में ही example है और उस example की help से इन्होंने इस concept को बहुत beautifully explain किया है. See friends, section 42 कहता है कि जब भी मैं private placement से कोई पैसा उठाती हूँ तो मुझे वो पैसा तभी यूज कर सकती हूँ जब मैं PS3 विच इज अ रिटर्न ऑफ अलॉटमेंट वो फाइल कर दूं. और मुझे PS3 फाइल करना होता है अलॉटमेंट के 15 दिन के अंदर अंदर. अब मेरे केस में क्या हुआ, मैंने PS3 फाइल नहीं किया, ठीक है, फाइल नहीं किया, CFSS स्कीम आ गई, इस स्कीम में मैंने PS3 फाइल कर दिया और मुझे कोई एडिशनल फीस नहीं देनी पड़ी. लेकिन मैंने बिना PS3 को फाइल किए वो पैसे को यूज कर लिया. दिस इज अ कॉन्ट्रोवेंशन ऑफ लॉ. और ये जो मैंने बिना PS3 फाइल किए पैसे को यूज किया है उसकी इस स्कीम में कोई माफी नहीं है. आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द कॉन्सेप्ट. जहां पे ये जो स्कीम है ये सिर्फ और सिर्फ फॉर्म की फाइलिंग को लेके आपने जो नॉन कंप्लायंस किया है उससे आपको बचा रही है. उसकी वजह से जो आपने लॉ का कॉन्ट्रोवेंशन किया है उससे आपको नहीं बचा रही. आई होप फ्रेंड्स दिस विद दिस एग्जांपल यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द कॉन्सेप्ट. सो अगेन जहां पे आपकी डिले की वजह से किसी पर्सन का इंटरेस्ट हैम्पर हो रहा है वहां पे आपको कोई माफी नहीं मिलेगी. दिस लाइन इज देयर इन द सर्कुलर एज वेल. So before going to modify the LLP settlement scheme, I just want to discuss the form with you. So I'll share my screen. Just a second. Okay, this is the MCA circular which came. This is the form. This is CFSS 2020 form. Again, you can see no name has been written because this is a draft form. First or second point may discuss. This is very simple, like writing name of the company and all that. Third point is, आपको क्या करना है? SRN numbers डालने हैं. आप जब SRN number डालोगे यहाँ पे, तो SRN number डाल के जब आप pre-fill करोगे, तो वो required details ले लेगा. जब आप CFSS 2020 form file करोगे. Again. This is something what professionals can do. जब वो इस scheme में filing करे specifically they can have a special folder जिसमें आप अपने forms और SRN save कर लें. They can maintain an Excel sheet as well. अगर हम ऐसा करते हैं तो जब हम CFSS 2020 form file करेंगे तो उसमें हमें बहुत help मिलेगी. So again fourth and fifth point, basically you are asking if any appeal was pending, then you have withdrawn it and the proof of withdrawal it has to be put in the attachment. So this is the form. again, if you see, this form has to be only signed by the director. You don't need to appoint any CA or CS for that. You just need the director to sign the form. Okay. And now this is the immunity certificate. If you see, specifically it is written, this immunity is from prosecution under Companies Act, and you know the certificate would mention the SRN numbers and documents also. So if you see the form also, the form is also very clear ki immunity sirf aur sirf filing ko leke mil rahi hai. Filing ki wajah se jo law ka default humne kiya, us par aapko koi immunity nahi mil rahi. So this was the form, friends. Now I'll you know, I hope you can see the PPT. Okay. No, you cannot see the PPT.
We cannot see the PPT. We can see the form.
Wait.
ROC form we can see.
Now can you see the PPT?
Yes, we can see.
Okay. So friends, now I'll discuss the modified LLP scheme. मैं ये बहुत ही brief में करूँगी, because I understand that you know we have got just time of 1 hour. So we'll start with modified LLP settlement scheme. ये scheme दो हिस्सों में आई थी. पहले वाली scheme 4th March को आई थी, फिर आपकी 30th March को scheme आई. Again, this scheme is also a one-time opportunity. जो भी LLPs की defaulted form से वो file कर सकती हैं और उनको कोई additional fees नहीं pay करनी. इसका general circle number 13/2020 है. Again, what is the difference between original scheme and new scheme? Two main difference I have given. First difference is again fees का था. First जो scheme आई थी उसमें आपको additional fees pay करनी थी. एंड जो अभी स्कीम आई है उसमें आपको कोई एडिशनल फीस नहीं करनी. फ्रेंड्स, सम पीपल हैव आस्क्ड मी कि उन्होंने ओरिजिनल स्कीम में पार्टिसिपेट करके डॉक्यूमेंट्स फाइल कर दिए थे तो क्या उनको रिफंड मिलेगा एडिशनल फीस का. नो, कोई रिफंड नहीं मिलेगा. जो आपने एक बार फाइलिंग कर दी और आपने पेमेंट कर दी, उसका कोई रिफंड नहीं मिलेगा. अगेन, सेकेंड थिंग, जो आपकी ओरिजिनल स्कीम आई है उसमें खाली 4 फॉर्म्स थे. जो आपकी नई स्कीम आई है उसमें 11 फॉर्म्स हैं. ये 11 फॉर्म्स मेंशन्ड हैं एमसीए की साइट पर. इसका पीरियड 16th मार्च से लेके 30th सितंबर है. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ डिफॉल्टिंग एलएलपी? डिफॉल्टिंग एलएलपी वही जिसने ड्यू डेट्स पे अपने डॉक्यूमेंट्स की फाइलिंग नहीं की, वो फाइलिंग कर सकती है और उसके लिए उसको कोई एडिशनल फीस नहीं देनी. एंड अगेन, दिस इज इम्पोर्टेंट, डिफॉल्टिंग एलएलपी इज परमिटेड टू फाइल रिलेटेड डॉक्यूमेंट विच वर ड्यू फॉर फाइलिंग टिल 31st August इन अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्रोविजन ऑफ दिस स्कीम. फॉर्म्स विच यू कैन फाइल, there's a list of 11 forms and the list is there in the 76 forms which are there on the MCA website. What are the exceptions? Strike off, again, agar aapka naam strike off ho gaya hai, then in that case you cannot participate in the scheme. Again, people ask, why should I opt for the scheme? You are being given chance to be more compliant. And again, this is something for CFSS also and for LLP scheme also, which I want to share. Friends, if you read both the circular, it says that this is a one-time opportunity. So by the meaning one-time opportunity, मैं ये भी समझ सकती हूँ कि हो सकता है इसके बाद MCA और ज़्यादा strict हो जाए. और ऐसी बहुत सारी companies हैं जिसको अभी तक उसने notices नहीं भेजा और इस स्कीम के एंड होने के बाद वो उनके ऊपर प्रोसिक्यूशन शुरू कर दे और तब आपको एडिशनल फीस तो देनी होगी, आपको पेनल्टी भी देनी होगी और प्रोसिक्यूशन भी झेलना होगा. सो इट्स बेटर कि तब आपको ये सब पे करना पड़े, उससे बेटर है अभी आप टाइम रहते अपने कंप्लायंसेस को कंप्लीट कर लो और ये गोल्डन अपॉर्चुनिटी जो दी है उसको अवेल कर लो. सो फ्रेंड्स, दिस वॉज माई प्रेजेंटेशन. I hope you liked it, and in case you have any queries, like you can ask.
Thank you, Padivadi. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Very nice deliberation. Thank we you. Have around 11 questions right now, and some okay. more questions are coming.
Okay.
We will start one by one.
Sangamji, let's ask them to raise the hand, and then we can allow them to speak, and they can ask their queries.
Acting those who have not raised their hand, but. Written some questions, so we can take that question first.
Let's ask them to raise hand or not.
Friends, please raise your hands. We will allow you to speak.
please raise your hand so that you can speak. Now, Virender Gupta ji, please speak. Virender ji.
Kindly unmute your mic.
Virender ji, you have raised your hand. Kindly unmute your mic if you have any query. Let's go with the next participants. Sonia ji.
Sonia ji, can you unmute your mic?
Sonia ji, you have any query? Can you unmute your mic? I think she's not having any query.
Okay, kindly, I think every participant are not mentally ready for the query. So we can first take queries which are in our question answer format.
Yeah, just better we can take the queries from the question answer hands.
So, Pratibha ji, there are three questions on similar similar topic. Now, okay. Filing of DR-11 is not mandatory. So, as you told us that if we have not filed DR-11 for some director, which are resignation, I think to a date, the word use this shall. After that, the word has been used may.
Uh-huh.
You are talking about for that period. When it is
yes, I am talking about for the period when it was mandatory, because you know this is for past documents. So when it was for the time when it was mandatory, and in that time we have not done the compliance, then you can for that time you can file at least the DIR-11 and you can make yourself more compliant.
So as on 6th May 2018, the provision has been changed. So those directors who have resigned before 6th May 2018,
they are supposed to check and then they are supposed to file the form. Right. And this was a learning for me as well. Good query.
There is same question asked by the four participant. In case of strike of a company by ROC, then in this scheme, is this scheme applicable?
See, I think I have already answered that question. In case the name has been striked off by the ROC, you cannot participate in the scheme.
But I think ROC has striked off the name of a company just because of non-filing of some past year documents.
No, see, once the name has been striked off, you cannot participate. The inactive company can participate, but if the name has been striked off, then you cannot participate in the scheme.
Is it possible ki firstly we can make our company activate and then file all pending?
But how would you do? It is a long process. You need to go to NCLT and then you need to make the company active.
And
you have to do it in the till 30th September. Do you think it would be possible? If it is possible and if you can make your company active, then you can definitely participate. But do you think it is possible?
Sangam ji, I think in that case, nobody will go for making the company active and then filing all the documents. Better in that case, they can create the new company. It will be the more easier process.
In some case, Deepak ji, we require a company who have a past history, having incorporation date 3 to 4 years to apply in tenders. So, and they didn't do any kind of compliance like annual filing. So, they are currently struggling for those companies to make activate because MC has strike off those company because of they are not filed for 4 year annual filing.
So the answer to that is that first you need to go to court. You need to activate yourself, and if you think you can do that in the tenure of 1st April to 30th September, then you can file the forms. But I don't think so that is possible.
Okay. Thank you. There is another question by Mr. Nitin Gupta. Can we apply for a refund for late fees paid to ROC?
No, you cannot apply. No refund would be given. I just told
late already, that cannot be refunded.
No, nothing. If you have paid the money, then it won't be refunded.
Okay. Mr. Meng Jain want to ask, sir, ma'am, after making an active status by filing INC 22A, then the company can apply in the scheme which has been strike off by the ROC due to non-filing?
No. See, I've told you again, if your name has been strike off, first you need to go to court and then only you can participate in the scheme. So if your name has been strike off, you cannot participate, ideally.
There are many participants whose companies have actually been strike off by ROC. They are more concerned and want to utilize the scheme because in case of strike off, their use penalty they are required to pay.
Yes, I understand.
Because recently, last 1 or 2 years, ROC has been strike of too many companies whose 4 year annual filing was not done. And for, if we do their 4 year annual filing right now, they have to pay huge amount of late fee. This is a major concern with the participants.
See, friends, in fact, this is a concern with the many of the people. I think in this case, what best we can do is we can give a representation to MCA and ask if the companies whose name have been strike off, they can make, you know, the procedure easy for them. As of now, for strike off, there are specific provisions in Companies Act, and those provisions have not been covered by the circular. So if you know, you need to go to court, and then you need to follow the procedure. So in case your name has been striked off, then I'm sorry to say that first you need to follow the procedure. And if you think you can follow the procedure within the given short tenure, then yes, you can participate. But the company whose name has been striked off, as of practically, it cannot participate. Okay. Maybe theoretically you can, after completing the procedure, then you can, but it is not practical because it is a situation of lockdown also.
Sangam ji and Pratibhaji,
I request you and your office to make a representation before MCA on this matter, because this is a very serious matter and many professionals are struggling and many companies are struggling because they have strike of many companies. So I really
Sangam ji. Hello. Yes, Sangam ji, I'm saying ki on this issue and the disqualification of directors issue, I think we should receive some clarification from the MCA. In the coming time, I think MCA will give something on these two issues, on the strike off and on the disqualification of the directors. There are many companies where director has been disqualified, and like Pratibha ji had said, ki, we can make them active by way of back-end procedure. That back-end procedure will be, a very tedious task considering the COVID-19. I don't know till how much time lockdown will continue. Since 1 month has already gone, that lockdown has been extended for 1 month. So after 3rd May, it will. We don't know whether it will open or not. So we are losing our time, and within this time, we need to do all the activities. So I think with the given time, MCA will come up with the solution for the in these two three matters. One is the strike off case. How can we do? How can we make companies active in case of the strike off? And in case of the disqualified directors, if there are only two directors, because that thing is not clear as of now, how we can make them active. One of the procedure is that we can go to the court. But if they are giving the immunity in all the cases where a person can do their compliances, then I think they should give immunity in these two cases also. They should provide some procedure in these two cases. So definitely we will give the presentation. We also will give the presentation. And one thing, one new thing should come from the MCA in these two matters.
Okay. Thank you very much, Deepak ji. There is a
this one more suggestion, yeah, which is there in my mind. Maybe we can request ICI to our Institute of Chartered Accountant of India to give some representation on this matter, and maybe we can ask them to make the things easier for the persons whose name have been striked off. Maybe that we can do.
Deepak ji, I request you to make a draft on the behalf of Study Cafe and we'll submit to the ICI. So that ICI can take it further to MCA.
Okay, Sangam ji, I noted and will submit it to the ICI.
Pratibha ji, there is another question by Shri Hari Rao. Hi.
Okay.
ROC strike off the name of a company and the company filed a petition before NCLT.
Okay.
The matter before the NCLT was strike off due to non-representation before the ROC by the company.
Okay.
In the given scenario, can the company file the form for restoration of its name by filing the necessary forms?
So this scheme is not for restoration of names, first thing, because I'll also request you, there's a list of forms, please stick to those forms only, because the forms which have been given in the list can only be filed. And again, in case of strike off, I am saying it again and again, first you need to follow the due procedure which is there in the different provisions, and after completion of that provisions, then if it is possible, because I think practically it is not possible, then you can participate in the scheme. Theoretically, you can participate, but practically you cannot participate.
Okay. Bengali, there is another question asked by our regular attendee, Miss Priyanka Agarwal. Okay. Thorough and understanding this session, please answer about if director disqualify under section 164(2).
Okay.
So please highlight on this point.
Priyanka, I need to read the provisions of 164(2) first of all, because it is something law. I think it needs to be read again and again to get more clarification. So I think you have got my number and email ID. Maybe after the webinar you can connect with me and then we can have a insight discussion on the topic. I hope you understand that.
Clear. Yeah, there is another question asked by Mr. Puneet. What is the best course of action for strike of company if it want to revive its status and want to be active compliant company? I think you already discussed.
I have already told you that it is something which is given in the provision, and then you have to follow those provisions only. So revive your company.
Okay. There is another question by our near and dear friend Tarun Kotraji. Company strike off, one director want to get its deal revive. How to proceed?
I just want to ask, there is a difference between DIN is deactivated and director is disqualified. So first I want to ask whether the director is disqualified or DIN is deactivated.
DIN is deactivated.
So in that case, first you need to complete your KYC. I told you in the presentation also, if your DIN is deactivated, first you need to complete your KYC. And after the KYC is complete, you can file rest of the forms. There is a MC advisory specifically for that. That is no issue.
Oh.
But if the director is disqualified, then you cannot do anything, because once the director is disqualified, he has to vacate his office and then he cannot be director of the company. Oh.
Thank you. There is another question by Ms. Alka Kumari Gupta. In case of all director disqualified, for more director appointed to file the form in the scheme, DSC of directors not working. Then in this,
I have already replied this thing. If DSC is not working, then there is a backend procedure which needs to be followed.
I'll repeat once again.
Yeah,
if all the directors of the companies are disqualified, so in that case, the promoters and shareholder, what they do is they appoint the director, and physical forms, they are submitted to ROC, and this is done through backend. And please note that the disqualified person, he cannot be appointed as a director. Some other person has to be appointed as the director of the company. So I hope the answer is satisfactory.
Yes.
There is another question on similar line asked by Mr. R.D. Sharma. How can director whose DIN deactivated due to non-filing of DR3 can activate it?
He can do the KYC, and once the KYC are complete, the DIN would be reactivated.
I think R.D. Sharma is here. Let me ask if he can speak whether DIN is deactivated or it is disqualified.
Please allow him to speak. R.D. Sharma sir, kindly.
R.D. Sharma sir, can you please unmute your mic and speak? Whether your DIN is disqualified, where director is disqualified, or DIN is deactivated, there is difference in both the things. Adi Sharma ji,
can you
uske jo master data mein jo likha raha hua raha deactivated due to non filing of DIR.
Sir, in this case, first you need to complete your KYC, and once you complete your KYC, your DIN would be reactivated. So that is no issue, and there is MC advisory also. Yes. Hello.
But company status is strike off.
So in this case, this is a case of disqualification. Then, जब strike off हो जाती है non filing की वजह से, वो non filing की वजह से तब strike off होती है जब उसने 3 साल तक की filing नहीं करी होती. और अगर कोई डायरेक्टर जिसकी कंपनी ने 3 साल की अपनी फाइनेंशियल्स को फाइल नहीं किया, तो बाय द एक्शन ऑफ लॉ ही इज डिस्क्वालिफाइड. इफ यू रीड सेक्शन 164, तो इन दिस केस द डायरेक्टर इज डिस्क्वालिफाइड, एंड दैट इज द रीजन दिस डिन इज नॉट वर्किंग.
हम इसको कैसे क्वालिफाई डायरेक्टर्स की
सर, एक बार डिस्क्वालिफिकेशन हो जाती है, देन यू कैन नॉट डू एनीथिंग एज ऑफ नाउ, बिकॉज़ इट इज समथिंग द लीगल प्रोसीजर इज देयर. and you need to go to court, and there is a specific procedure which is given in the Companies Act. But this scheme is not for the disqualified director. If you are disqualified director, then you cannot participate in the scheme. But for company, it can do is it can appoint new directors from back end. The promoter of the company can appoint new persons as director of the company, and the company can complete the filing. But the person who is a disqualified director, the scheme is not for that person.
That Addition. Procedure will be through NCLT only.
Yes, through court, through NCLT. High court. In case of disqualification, you need to go to High Court, and in case of revival of the company, you need to go to NCLT.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Can you allow another participant to ask?
Yeah. Rinka Agarwal. Rinka, you can speak. What is your query?
Hello.
Hi, Priyanka.
Thanks to all of you. Very nice session there.
Thank you.
As discussed from Rosie Pratibha ma'am, I have cleared my query. If the director is disqualified, then it's not possible for a such director to file forms under CFSS.
No, Priyanka, if he's a disqualified director, see, understand. Mm-hmm. Once a person is disqualified, he cannot be become director under Companies Act, because a disqualified person cannot become director. And since the day of his disqualification, he's supposed to vacate his office. So he cannot act as a director once he's disqualified.
I'm sharing you my question through example. A director is a director in a ABC Private Limited.
Okay.
This is striked off due to non-filing of the forms. But
okay.
He is also a director in a EFG company.
Okay.
Who is active non-compliant. Or in which he is a director.
Yes. Okay. Priyanka, I'm getting your question. You are saying that he has become disqualified because one of the company has not done filing of more than 3 years. And because of that reason, since he's disqualified, can he be the director? Can he act as a director in another company? I hope this is your question.
My question is this. The prior company is striked off.
Okay.
But now the present company is non-filing. Is not completed due to the disqualification of him or her.
Priyanka, in this situation also, I just told you that there is a back-end procedure for ROC, and the promoters and shareholders of the company can appoint someone else as the director of the company. After the required number of directors are appointed, you can complete the filing.
Okay. Ma'am, in this COVID-19 situation, is it not possible for all of us, as we are all professionals and the associates are working from home and trying to provide the services to our valuable clients?
Yes.
My question is here, what effort we will do this now at the current scenario?
This is what you are saying is practical, because practically you cannot go to ROC and submit the forms. At best, what we can do is we can give representation. Maybe they should allow us a submission of forms through email or something like that facility they should start. But as of now, what you are saying is right. Practically, we cannot go to ROC because of lockdown.
Exactly.
Or we can wait to open the lockdown. Thereafter, we can...
At the best, we can wait for the lockdown to be over, and then maybe we can go and submit the document.
And one more thing I would like to add, if this lockdown is going to be extended, let's say it will be extended for 2-3 months, then I think ROC will extend this scheme as well. This scheme should be extended in that case.
Yes, there are chances. We can anticipate that also.
Because if we professionals, nobody is able to go offices, so we cannot do anything by sitting at home. All our DSCs are in offices and at clients' place. So, and without DSC, we cannot file any form on the MCA. So we are expecting, if there is no solution came and the lockdown is extended, so in that case, this scheme will be extended.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, no issue.
Do I need another question? You allow someone else to speak?
Yeah, let me check. Rahul Bansal is there and Nitin Bansal is there. Whether they are raised hand, Rahul and Nitin.
No, I think Nitin Bansal not raised the hand.
Rahul Bansal, you can speak if you have any query. You have asked, can we file one of the director is disqualified due to non-compliance by other company? If his question is not complete, probably you want to ask, can we file if one director is disqualified due to non-compliance by other company? You want to ask, can we file forms if one director is disqualified due to non-compliance by other company?
Again, I think I've already answered this question. If the director is disqualified, this is something what Priyanka has asked. So
in this question, we want to ask, suppose Mr. A is the director in a company ABC. The company is not made any default, but the other company PQR which made a default, because of that company Mr. A become disqualified. So in ABC, can we file these forms?
I've already answered. This is what Priyanka's query was, that one company is suffering because of disqualification of the director and the company is perfect in its filing. So again, the answer is same. You need to appoint new directors from backend and then they can do the filings. But if the director is disqualified, he cannot act as the director, and you need to appoint someone else as the director of the company, and then you can do the filing.
Yes. Next query is from the Nitin Bansal.
Multiple directors, other all directors are qualified. In that case also we need to appoint.
No. See, if you have got more than, if the number of directors which are required as per the act, if that you are able to satisfy it, then you don't need to disqualify it. This solution was specifically bought for the private companies. There were many private companies which were having only two directors, and the both of the directors were disqualified due to this problem. So this is only for in that case when number of directors which are required for filing are not complete, then we should opt for the procedure. If the number of directors is complete, then we can do the filings. At least the company should not suffer because of that.
Okay. Next question is from the Nitin Bansal. Nitinji, you can speak.
Hello.
Yes, sir. We can listen
to
you.
Yes, Nitinji.
Audible, ma'am.
Yes, you're audible.
I want to ask that, suppose I have to remove a director from our company.
Okay.
This is the period of COVID-19. Can we do this by video conferencing meeting?
Video conferencing, there is another circular of MCA. They are allowing video conferencing meetings for conducting board meeting, and the circular says you can do it for earlier there were certain exceptions in the Companies Act when you could not do video conferencing meeting for those things. Physical presence has to be there, but MCA has relaxed these things, and you can do it with the help of video conference meeting.
What evidence we have to cap that?
I think the recording has to be kept in case of video conferencing.
Recording Achha. Of the meeting you can keep, and the screenshot of the meetings, like if you are doing from the laptop or mobile, you must be seeing the screens of the other directors. So you can capture that screenshots and recording of the meetings you can keep.
I would like to have another question. Our one company has not filed documents since 2014.
Okay.
Hello?
Due to
the death of the one director.
Okay.
And we had filed for a strike-off of the same company, mm-hmm. but RBC had that you had to file any documents.
Okay. See, in then case you have applied, but in case you have applied for strike off, then you cannot participate in the scheme. I think I've made it very much.
But ROC had itself said that you had to file all pending documents, and our strike off not completed till now.
Okay, so in this case, you need to since you your issue is that the required number of directors are not complete, so you need to appoint someone else as the director of the company, and then when the required number of directors have been appointed, then you can file the documents.
Is there any additional fees? Shall we levy it on
No, in this scheme, if you are participating, no additional fees would be levied. One query. I hope your company is an active company. It is not the name as then no additional fees will be levied. If it is an active company, then you can very much follow the procedure. Then it is no issue.
Okay.
Now we are taking questions from the YouTube. There are many queries on the YouTube as well. So let me ask one by one. Chandra Vijay Shahji asking, NCLT revives the, can you hear me?
Yes, yes, you're audible.
Yeah, NCLT revives the struck off company with penalty. Whether waiver of such penalty is recovered by the scheme, will
no,
CFS?
No, I think no, refund. I've already said no refund would be given. If once what you have paid has gone into government's treasury, and you cannot get any refund.
Another query is from the Mr. Mukesh Solanki. Is it applicable for form CHG1?
Please, I request you to check the list of the forms, because all the forms I also don't remember. It is not possible for me to remember all the forms. Please, I request you. CHG1 is, I think, charge related. So, charge related documents are not covered. I have already said that. No, charge related documents are not covered.
Now, another query is from the Chandra Vijay Shahji. Suppose AOC 4 for 2019-20 is due by 30th June 2020, but may be filed on 1st July 2020, delayed by one day only. Can company opt to file it with the additional fees of 100 and to avoid form? Yes, he can do it via
the quantum of the scheme. Quantum of the penalty, the late fees is not an issue. So you can file.
Yeah. And annual filing of 18-19 is still pending. Company can avail the scheme. However, will it be required to pay additional fees due date till 31st March 2020?
No additional fees is required to be paid in this case.
And he's asking another query. Can form CFSS be filed after 31st March 2020 with additional fees? I think no.
CFSS, first thing, CFSS, you don't need to pay any fees with CFSS. It is free of cost. And no, you cannot file it. There's a tenure specified in the circular, and you have to file the form within the tenure.
Okay, and for another query is from the Mukesh Solanki. A company annual return not filed form 16 for financial 16-17. Can they go through the scheme and file INC 22A and annual returns?
Yes, the forms are covered. If you're an active company, you can file.
Puneet Nathwani is asking, what is the best course of action for strike of company if it wants to revive its status and wants to be active compliant company?
I think I've told you the answer. You need to go to NCLT because the course is not specified in the circular.
Another question is from Mr. Lunawat. What is the cutoff date with reference to newly incorporated company where additional 180 days is allowed to file commencement of business?
I think this scheme is
not... This is not for the new company. It is the existing. Mukesh Solanki is asking again. Auditors are appointed, but company has not filed annual returns and not conducted AGM also. What will be the auditor's responsibility?
This is a very good question. Again, I had this query somewhere. The query is that ICAI says that you need to, as an auditor, if you are signing some document, you need to generate UDIN for that. Now, the scheme has come. My query is that if you are doing filing of, I think when we did filing of 18-19, we were supposed to generate UDIN. So what if someone has not done the filing of, someone has not done the audit of 18-19, because this is what practically has happened. If someone has not done the filing, he has not done the audit and everything. So now if the person comes to me and he says that please do my audit of 18-19 and I want to participate in the scheme, and once you do the audit, you audit the balance sheet and everything, and I can participate in the scheme, but maybe I can but I cannot generate UDIN in this case.
I think I request Mukesh ji to call Pratibha ji after the meeting, then only she'll be able to give the better answer on the public
better
forum.
Answer for that. Because this is one of my query.
Yeah, okay. In this case, I think we cannot generate UDIN in back date, and we have to sign the such balance sheet which we audited in current date. We should have write the current date of audit and generate the UDIN with current date. We cannot generate the UDIN with the back date.
No, but as per Companies Act, you are supposed to do your audit. There is a timing for that. You are supposed to conduct your AGM till 30th September, and then
that day you have to apply for extension of AGM. But okay. Auditor can sign in back date because UDIN is not possible to generate in back date. So practically, okay. It's not possible to sign in back dates.
So this is, I think, which I wanted to ask personally. So I think some of the queries on YouTube channel are pending. They can, ask me on email or call. I would answer them.
Sanjay Gupta ji is asking if company active after strike off and file all due form can now file immunity from the immunity. We have already answered. Once you have paid the fees, that cannot be refunded. Now one query is coming here as well on the Zoom webinar. Sunil Agarwal ji. In one case, the company has not filed any annual return since 2016, but having the status of the company, directors would become disqualified for filing of annual returns of the year ending 2019. Can the same director participate in the scheme 2019 also? I think his director is already disqualified.
If the directors are disqualified, then directors cannot participate in the scheme. The company, again, I told you the procedure, the company has to appoint new directors from back end and then only they can participate.
Sunil Agarwal ji, if you can listen, you can unmute your mouth and speak again. Sunil ji, can you listen us?
Yes,
he's listening. Now you can ask your query. Your question was not little clear. Sunil ji, you can speak.
Yes. My query was that the directors for the period 2016, 17, and 18 can file the form under this said scheme.
Directors, I think if the directors are not disqualified, they can, and the company is in active position, they can very much file the form. If the company is active and directors are not disqualified, then they can file the form.
Okay.
Friends, you can ask your all the question by through Pratibha ji. His email ID and mobile number are given. You can WhatsApp her instead of call, and we assure you will get the reply of your query. So, Deepaji, should we conclude the session?
Yes, we can conclude. We have asked all the queries from the YouTube.
End of our schedule. So, I express my heartiest thank to Pratibha ji to participate in today's deliberation. We enjoy the deliberation too much, as we can understand the number of queries are coming. So, we have handled more than 30 queries. This shows that our attendees are having interactive session with you. So thank you very much to coming on this platform and discuss very important and latest topic with our attendees. So now hand over to Deepak ji.
Friends, I would say still I can see there are a lot of people are raising hands, but they are not asking here. So in case if you have any query, you can speak to Pratibha ji after the session, and your queries will be resolved. And most of the people is having the queries of the strike off and the disqualification of the directors, which we have already told that, what is the procedure as of now. But let's wait for the sometime if anything new comes from the MCA side in case of the disqualification of the directors and in case of the company strike off. And the fees that you have already paid, many people are asking this thing that they have already paid the fees in case of the revival. So that fees, they cannot get back that they have already paid it. Now let's conclude the session. I would like to thank you, Pratibha ji, for taking this session. It was very interactive session, and since a lot of people are asking queries, and thank you very much, and for clearing our doubts, and thank you Sangam ji for supporting us, and thank you friends for listening us, and giving us so much love that you are providing, and because of that we are coming daily basis, and our webinar schedules has been fixed for next 7 days. Probably that also we will share in advance for next 7 days which webinar we are going to conduct. Thank you very much friends, and please today since the chat options were disabled because of some technical issues, we were not able to share the link of our tomorrow's webinar session. That link we will share in the YouTube channel, and we will communicate you through the WhatsApp. Thank you very much friends.
Thank you very much friend. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.